I'm Monica Pearson with This Week in Black History. It was on this day in 1968 that the Marvin Gaye and Tammi Terrell duet Ain't Nothing Like the Real Thing topped the Billboard R&B charts. The single was one of a series of hits for the two vocalists, who began working together in 1966 with a classic ballad, Ain't No Mountain High Enough. Marvin Gaye was an established Motown artist by that time, with hits like How Sweet It Is and It Takes Two. Terrell had just signed with Tamla Records a year earlier, singing backup on tracks by Stevie Wonder and the Isley Brothers, and had endured two abusive relationships with James Brown and the Temptations' David Ruffin. She found a friend in Marvin Gaye, and the two recorded the duet album United in 1967. It also featured the Spinners on background vocals. Sadly, the success enjoyed by Gaye and Terrell was short-lived. In late 1967, Tammi Terrell began experiencing constant migraines and even collapsed into Marvin's arms at a show in Virginia. A doctor's examination revealed a malignant tumor on the right side of her brain. Despite multiple surgeries, Terrell was forced to retire from performing. Her last public appearance was in 1969, singing a final duet with Marvin Gaye at the Apollo Theater, their hit, You're All I Need to Get By. Terrell passed away in 1970 at the young age of 24. Her mother refused to let anyone from Motown attend the funeral, except for Marvin Gaye, who delivered her final eulogy. In 1999, Ain't No Mountain High Enough was inducted into the Grammy Hall of Fame.